Kansas City United Center in Chicago. And the CBS Sports Classic doubleheader for you. Game one, the Buckeyes of Ohio State and the Bruins of UCLA. And we welcome you to Chicago, everybody. Happy holidays. Brad Nessler along with Bill Raftery. Jamie Erdahl will be along in just a minute. Raft, this is the third time you and I have gotten together for the CBS Sports Classic. A little pre-Christmas cheer of these two games.
Yeah, you know, it's amazing. Of course, whoever wins is going to enjoy Christmas a lot more, but four teams, probably we'll see them in March.
Well, for Ohio State, they're off to a great start. Not only 10-1 and ranked in the top 20, but 2-0 in the Big Ten. Powered by Wesson, my friend.
Ooh, you love him. The ability to maneuver people. He has a extreme capability of using the derriere, the drop step spin. He is a tough out. I just love his footwork. He's got quicker, really understands how to finish deals, and he also is a great feel for the game. Terrific passer as well.
UCLA got off to a good start. They got up to number 17 in the country early in the season. Then the wheels started to wobble a little bit, and I mean, they almost fell off in the past two games. A loss to Belmont, and then they got hammered on Wednesday night by Cincinnati, and Chris Wilkes, their star player, had this to say after the game. They need to get in the gym. They need more meetings. They need something, because they can't have losses like the two they've just suffered. With more on that, here's Jamie.
Yeah, Brad, Santa hasn't quite delivered what Steve Alford hoped for UCLA basketball in this week leading up to their three-day holiday break. He told me that game at Cincinnati, the reality check was, for about a half a dozen of his players, that was their first true road college basketball game. He said their backs are against the ropes. Now the decision the players have to make is, do you come out swinging or do you dance around the ring? The answer will about to be, we'll find out, guys.
Boy, that's the truth. And Wrapped. I guess every coach has been there. I know you went through it at times. How do you straighten it out?
Hey, don't pick on me on this day. I would say they're in disarray. Watching practice yesterday, the demands, the coaching staff really getting after players. They played pretty. This is not a pretty game. It's all about toughness. Let's see if they're tough enough this afternoon.
And they have to be tough against an Ohio State team as we take a look at our AT&T fast analysis.
The ability to make some plays, ball movement, dribble drive. Ohio State does a great job of getting the touch in the lane and spotting up in corners with the ability, and a lot of guys can knock down the tray, and the ability of the big guy to find people, unselfish. He'll see some doubles, I'm sure. At the other end, it's all about the good hands movement, the ability to get in the lane, finish or find. And Jalen Hands is talented. A lot's going to be asked of him this afternoon. He is to play at his optimum.
Can UCLA come back and play tough against Ohio State? We'll find out. Pac-12, Big Ten, Game 1, next. The CBS Sports Classic is sponsored by Coca-Cola. Enjoy Coca-Cola with those who make the season special. AT&T, more for your thing, that's our thing. And by Sonic, this is how you Sonic. In the Bruins, the Buckeyes at 10-1, 2-0 in the Big Ten. Chris Holtmann in his second season, the reigning Big Ten Coach of the Year a season ago. And his Buckeyes, the starting lineup looks like this. A little change in there, and that Woods is making his third start with Muhammad Jackson, Wesson, and Wesson, the Wesson brothers, the big guy for the Bruins of UCLA. Three-guard lineup with Ali Wilkes and Hands, Riley and Brown up front for Steve Alford in his sixth season as the head coach of the Bruins. The officials today, Roger Ayers, Lamar Simpson, and Dick Cartmell, after 35 years, 24 NCAA tournaments, 5 Final Fours, and 3 national championships. This is Dick's final game. Talked to him before the game. I said, really? You're giving it up? He almost started crying when he was talking to us. It's been a remarkable career. He's a great official, great guy, and he's going to throw it at center court for the final time.
Ooh, a little steal by Moses there on the toss. But by the way, Dick is a class act. All coaches love to see him on a ball game. You say it to see him, but how about this little steal?
Whew. Got another way up.
Wow, I'll say. And right now, Brad Nessler, good to be with you in Chicago. as UCLA goes out with
the... Wesson will be the guy.
They pack it into him immediately against Moses on the inside. The big fella up under and missed it. And then bumps.
And a bad foul, too.
Bad foul.
He has a habit of getting cheap ones, and that really puts them into a difficult situation.
That's something to watch for both teams. Same thing with Moses Brown, the 7-1 freshman for UCLA. They can ill afford to get either one of those guys in trouble.
And Moses, pretty good offensive rebounder. Little baby hook. Good use of the floor here.
Prince Ali on top.
It's important early for UCLA to get a comfort zone.
Ali on the drive. The dish underneath to the big fella, and Moses Brown hammers it home.
How about a ring of bell there?
Ooh, drive in. Fine.
We'll try to keep the Wessons separated for you.
Mm-hmm.
One's a lot bigger than the other. But.
Exactly. He got late to the dinner table. A little perimeter play by Andre. And he can make this three now. Shooting with confidence.
And does.
The big fella. How about both of us watching his footwork yesterday?
Yeah.
Incredible.
For 270 pounds.
You're used to that, though. The weekend
footwork.
Yeah. Well, you know, you see some big guys during the SEC season.
Yes, I do.
Nice help.
They lob it inside again to Brown. A double team on him. They kick out for three off the mark. Rebound, C.J. Jackson.
If you think he can play Moses straight up, everybody can stay at home on shooters. This is where they're going to go. He likes to bounce. Got a little game with both hands. Look at this power.
And he works baseline and draws the foul. So both big guys have won early.
It'll be interesting to see if they make a little bit of adjustment. If they rake a little bit, go down and help on occasion. Maybe on one bounce, go after him. He's just got too much power and experience by the big guy. He'll pick and pop, and you can just see Moses, a little delinquent, covering.
So Caleb Wesson, free throw good, off to a four-point start here.
Now, you mentioned that Cincy game. They really just were men against youngsters that particular game, UCLA, and it'll be interesting to see how competitive they will be. And you got to really get after it, realize the guys at the other end, they're all business. You've got to be.
Ohio State's only loss was to Syracuse by 10. There's a lob underneath, and they get it to Moses Brown again.
And that's the thing about hands. He's really feeling his way into that point guard position. It is the little combo guard that he is right again, the little 2-3 zone now.
And it pays off for him. Aaron, ball handling by Jackson. Going the other way. Putback is good.
Well, I like the hustle early by UCLA. Everybody getting down the floor that time. Wilkes, who has been steady for this team on the offensive end, Brad.
He's been their mainstay, averaging almost 18 a game. Whistle and a foul.
Not a good handle on that particular play.
C.J. Jackson
with the giveaway. Right here in the right spot. You can see you step up. You can't get that weak side coverage. And the open floor opportunity. You see the blue shirts dominate here.
C.J. Jackson goes to the bench. Back to back. Aaron plays. First he lost the handle. Then he got a cheap foul. And Chris Holtman sits him. And that brings Kyle Young in. Young normally a starter. Didn't start today. We mentioned Woods instead. Nice drive inside.
How about that penetration and attack?
Riley,
tough kid. He's a low post. Tell you, he is a stud down there.
And back-to-back turnovers. Ohio State not giving themselves any chances. Lob underneath.
Nice
Brown
run.
Reverse missed it. And Wesson with a rebound.
Nice look by Hands. You got to get back, though. Young.
Young underneath.
And a nice, great look by Woods. Woods got a great feel for the game. Experience, been around.
Like you said to me before the game, doesn't matter to him whether he started or not. He could care less.
No, exactly. He just he understands his role. Screens, slips, rebounds, guards. Shows well on ball screens, Young.
Here's Riley. Nice spin move against Young in the paint.
I like the move, though. Going to his offhand.
Nice ball movement by the Buckeyes to get a three. Open look. A little too strong. Rebound off to Ali. Prince will back it up. And he got it right back for a three of his own.
Western really not running the floor right now. A little bit winded after 4 minutes. This limits his individual play here, the zone.
Baseline drive on a floater, no good. Wesson got the miss, triple teamed underneath. And he's fouled.
Is it on Brown?
No, I don't think so. Yes, it is.
Wow, number two, that hurts them.
That's bad news for UCLA.
Get in that lane and get some there. Riley, the life of Riley in Chicago. Fine finish.
Looking for a sports network without yelling and hot takes? Try CBS Sports HQ, the 24/7 network committed to making you a smarter fan. Just news, stats, highlights, picks, and fantasy advice. Always on, always free. Watch on the CBS Sports app now.
Now, there's nothing more gratifying when you get opportunities to get easy baskets, the ability to run the floor. You can just see the leak out here. This has got to be protected. You got to see the basketball. Heads turn. That's not good defense. And Young of Heart, big time, send it in.
Yeah, we want to straighten things out. Going to the break, we thought for sure Roger Ayers said one, which would have been the foul on Moses Brown. It was two, Cody Riley. So that's good news for the Bruins, or their big guy would have been in foul trouble here early.
Very important, no question about it. Hill on the floor now. This is a team I think they can play smaller as well. A lot of hype for Moses Brown when you think of it, comparing him because of New York to Lou Alcindor.
Yeah, right.
I mean, he's a work in progress. It's going to take him a long time to understand the game. And people are going to go at him, move him around, really go at him physically. Doesn't get in a good defensive stance.
Caleb Wesson just came in to hit one of his two free throws. Now they're going to give him a breather.
And Jackson back on the floor. To me, he's the most important guy in this Ohio State team. Running the show, getting people involved. A little double high, pick and pop and roll.
Hands the kick out to Wilkes for three. Off the backside, Young will clear it ahead to Jackson. CJ, who had a couple of turnovers before he hit the bench. As Raph said, he's an important cog to their offense. Here he is against the zone again.
1-2-3. You know, early in the season, teams aren't comfortable playing this kid as an offensive weapon. He hunched shot Washington that time. A little bit off.
Chris Smith with the rebound. Just checked into the UCLA lineup. Three-pointer goes for Jalen Hand.
Loves that freeze three. Gets you rocking, back on the heels, and drills it.
Andre Wesson playing in the middle of that zone right now. They move it around the perimeter. The kick out. Jackson gets it back.
Makes you use a lot of clock. Great aggressive D right now.
And one.
Not a good foul. Got him on the side there. That's the experience able to deliver. You think Steve Alford watched the Syracuse tape?
No doubt. They lost by 10 against the Syracuse zone, and he's trying the same thing.
Yeah, absolutely. You can see the elevation there. This kid is a player.
Jack, one shot. Keyshawn making his third start of the season today, averaging just under 9 points a game.
And the more you watch him, he handles it well. He got a nice pull-up middle game. Good compliment. Young's got a tough matchup with Hill. A little rubs on the baseline, particularly on the offensive glass. I think Hill can do some damage.
A little different look for UCLA with the exception of their star player. Goes baseline and got it off the window. Chris Wilkes, a chance for a three-point play.
How about that? Great movement and motion using the rubs on the baseline. Just the activity here. That's just gorgeous basketball. And then right here, the use of their rim. Great extension with his legs.
Averaging 17.7 a game. Three-point play. Doesn't get it.
The middle is wide open. I think you get a shooter or a small forward in that foul line. Decision, nice kick.
Wesson kicks it out for a three-pointer. Young again cleans up on the offensive glass.
That's what he does. A little dirty work. Kyle. Actually, he was going to go to Butler, as you well know, and then Chris took this job. And what a real good, solid contributor this kid is. Knows how to screen off, Pretty good offensive weapon on the glass.
Sophomore out of Canton, Ohio, and off the window. I don't know if he called that, but he'll take it.
Wow, it's a little drifty here since Jordan left.
Tied at 13.
Once again, same little set. Box and then a cross screen and a pin.
Wilkes going to work. Steps. And he walks.
Good call.
13:43 to go in the half. Tomorrow, 60 Minutes explores a small island nation in the Mediterranean with a mythic past. What kind of history is it making today? Plus, running with the Wolves of Yellowstone. That's the only thing Raft has never done. That's tomorrow. That's 60 Minutes. You run with a lot of things, but not the Wolves.
I don't know if they take American Express. There's a Jallo in there. He can make a three. That's why he's on the floor right now. Wesson's another guy.
Andre Wesson on the baseline. They double him, try to pack it into Young and throw it away. Wilkes on the drive. Woo-hoo! And the finger roll.
How about that? In traffic, able to protect and finish.
Well, he had those comments after the Cincinnati game. He's doing his part right now, I'll tell you that much.
Bernard on the floor now, another guy that can really be aggressive.
Somehow.
Nice pass.
Washington got his own rebound, and now Wilkes will clear off the miss.
Competing, that's what UCLA's doing right now. Ohio State's got to get a little comfort zone on how to attack that zone.
Jules Bernard out on top right now for UCLA.
Boy, I love the activity off those post screens.
I haven't had to mention the shot clock until right now, I guess. Wilkes for three. Got it.
What patience.
5-point UCLA lead.
What did you think of UCLA's practice? You think it was pretty involved yesterday?
No, I didn't, actually. Not compared to the other three teams we saw.
Well, no, I meant the verbal end of it. The coaching loss.
Oh, yeah. There was a lot of that going on.
Yeah, exactly. A lot of teaching.
Yeah, Steve was not quiet at practice yesterday.
That's what Bernard loves to go to the hole, closes the turnover, though.
On the drive and off the window, Dwayne Washington.
Kid is an aggressive offensive player.
Under the 12-minute mark, UCLA by three. Without hands out there, UCLA doesn't look quite as comfortable.
And you can hear Steve in the background, move, move. It isn't as coordinated. Hands is a leader at that point position, and they just haven't been able to get somebody to give him those few minutes and run the show as effectively. Well, you got to cut, I think, against this zone. You can't stand still and settle for shots like that.
Jackson just hoisted one.
They're perplexed. Early in the year, zone can be a factor.
Wilkes got to look at a three, partially blocked, I think, by Jallo.
Good aggressive play.
Well, Caleb Wesson's going to be well rested by the time we get a TV timeout here. I'll tell you that much.
Well,
there is the foul.
It might be Bernard on the reach, and I'm not sure.
Chris Wilkes, sophomore out of Indianapolis. He's done everything for the Bruins here in the first half, inside and outside. Next Saturday, starting at 5:30 Eastern, CBS Sports Network brings you College Hoops doubleheader, tipping off number 16, Wisconsin, battles Western Kentucky, followed by Oregon visiting Boise State at 7:30. Next Saturday, CBS Sports Network. CBS Sports Classic here in Chicago. This is the fifth year of the Classic, and there's the records of the four teams so far. North Carolina with the best mark. They'll play Kentucky in our second game. And 2 years ago, we had one of the best games I think I've ever seen a regular season play. Raft and I, 103-100. That was a beauty.
Incredible. Monk went off and just amazing names. Of course, the great history. We saw some of those shots on the open. Lucas and Havlicek at Ohio State. There's John Wooden and his unbelievable run. Dean Smith, Matt McGuire, Carolina. You name it.
26 championships between the four teams we're seeing here today.
And right now, real problem for Ohio State. Trying to handle it. Some ball screens down on the wing, running baseline.
Wesson hit the deck. Two big guys battling underneath. Three on the shot clock. Got to hurry. Caleb Wesson from the elbow. Oh, what a follow, but a miss. Would have been spectacular. Jallo got way up there.
He can elevate.
I like the pace that UCLA's playing with. Playing with some confidence. This is where Ohio State has to get themselves involved in a nice little post-up.
Yep, Riley lost the handle. UCLA turns it over. There's Jackson coming the other way. And still Ohio State ball.
Look at Muhammad on the floor now. See if he can get a little bit of juice. But how about this ability? He is a big time. Pretty impressive. Because you don't get the body on people on the offensive glass. So if you can get good shots, soft finish, somebody can tip it in.
They whip it out. Luther Muhammad. Again, they've got Wesson on the inside against Brown off the window. Caleb doing his part. Leading scorer for Ohio State. He's got eight.
This is the run they had earlier. The baseline bumps, now ball screen. He can make that shot. That's what I like about Riley.
Wilkes not on the floor right now for UCLA.
And a five again. Pretty good defense.
And an offensive foul.
Yes, nothing. Can't afford those giveaways. Got to get shots of UCLA. And Chris got to get a little rhythm offensively. They haven't been able to establish anything on this end. I think you got to drive the gaps a little bit more. Almost like Syracuse, how the wing comes all the way up, Brad. See Riley way up, and then they exchange.
And again, Ohio State can only work it around the perimeter. Finally, they get back in. Caleb Wesson.
There's a nice job going opposite.
Back inside of the big fella.
Got to finish that. Doing a nice job. Moses on the floor, drags Wesson. I think you got to move Wesson around.
Riley on the drive.
And we got a foul, yeah. They work on that. Nice step in by the big guy, offering up the big body. He certainly is a big body to offer up,
absolutely.
I might add.
Absolutely.
And he needed a little dribble drive and selling it big time. But the big guy at the other end, I think he's just got a nice kick opposite. And his ability to finish has been pretty successful thus far in the season for Ohio State.
Riley sits with two fouls. With just under nine to go in the half. Other than Caleb Wesson, what are the Buckeyes going to do offensively?
Well, they're matching up here. You've got to get an odd man. Have two guys playing one.
Jackson got to look for three.
And
trying to crash the board is going to be a foul on Luther Muhammad.
Yeah, Luther Muhammad, aggressive player, a Jersey guy. Going to have a nice career. Coach Nick Marinella, Hudson Catholic. Of course, St. Anthony's used to turn out some great players under Hurley, obviously. And all of a sudden, Hudson Catholic established their own powerhouse.
And that one is going to Ohio State.
Now they just try to sell it. These are the kind of mistakes you can't afford to have.
That one was heading to Rafts. So probably would have dropped it had it taken one more bounce.
I always drop it unless it's near the hole. Trying to speed up. Chris saying play a little quicker. We're using a lot of shot clock at the other end by UCLA.
Here's Woods penetrating. Wesson with a rebound, blocked. Nice job defensively by UCLA.
And Wesson does a great job sealing off to give that entree. Woods gets right to the rim just because the big guy's able to turn his man and just solid pin him. Oh, you got to finish it.
Great triple team on Wesson. The ball over on the possession arrow to UCLA. There's a lot.
Boy, you got to pay attention. Establish that pivot foot.
Bernard, I actually thought he had one earlier in the game. He got away with not that one.
Steve's been down the road. I mean, he's been successful every place he's been. The young group.
a lot of bright lights in their careers. You know, you're being tested. That's what this is all about. Are you willing to reach back, establish yourself in the game, compete?
The Bruins.
Nice cut.
And Brown got way up there. Didn't block the shot, but he altered it, I think, a little bit.
And a well-rested hands. Nice hesitation.
Pull up. Jumper goes. Prince Ali's first basket.
And I love the way Hands broke down the defense, collapsed it, found his partner. You got to keep cutting and moving the basketball as well. Nice entry here.
Woods found himself a little spot, kicks it back out, and now Jackson on a floater.
Nice job. All because of ball movement and a nice dive to the box.
First basket for C.J. Jackson. 1-point game as we approach 7 minutes and a half. Hands on the inside, has to bring it back on top. Around the back by Ali, and UCLA turns it over again. 6:53 remaining first half, 1-point game in Chicago. Our game summary, Ohio State struggling from the floor right now. Caleb Wesson leads the way with 8 points, 5 rebounds. Wilkes, on the other hand, the guy that made the comment, if you missed it in the open, that they need to do something to turn things around from what happened against Cincinnati on Wednesday night. He's doing his part.
Well, when you speak up, you better back it up.
That's
and
right.
He sure has early. Other than turnovers, they've had their problem. Nice ball movement. He's able to get the puppies organized and drill it. But valuing the ball is key. And how about the power of the big guy? Great extension. Didn't finish. The little giveaway was silly. He can't afford those kind of touch fouls. But the ability of Ohio State now to recognize and dive is a little bit better on the offensive end. They've been struggling against this 2-3 zone.
Well, UCLA has been in it virtually from the start. I think they played man-to-man just so Rapp could say man-to-man at the beginning of the game. And then
we have
zone.
A deal. We've got an arrangement.
They get it to Woods from the free throw line.
Well, you got to make that. Nice entry.
Nice offensive rebound. Caleb Wesson trying to dish it back to his brother and threw it away.
Carry. Good. That's the
nine turnovers.
That's unbelievable. You just see they're not themselves yet.
Jamie?
Steve Alford not going to be happy about that because he was just in the huddle harping on the guard play. He pretty much told the guards, your play has been atrocious. We talked about dancing in the ring at the beginning. They've been dancing. Unfortunately, it's been with the basketball, not dribbling at the same time.
Exactly.
So I can only imagine what the next huddle is going to be.
You got to dribble if you're going to dance.
Well,
Ohio State gives it right back to him.
Well, that would have been a perfect back cut on Jackson.
They feed it inside to Wilkes. Got his own miss and put it back in.
Just nice dive to that rim area. Other than the turnovers, they've been pretty good, UCLA.
Yeah, they have.
When you do play zone, you take away individual ability. You got to rely on teamwork, cuts. Pretty good look there, huh?
Got it into the younger Wesson, Andre.
And Woods with a nice find.
Actually, Andre's the older Wesson. I knew I'd mess that up
by
at some
a year.
Point today, yeah.
And how about him early in the year with the three teeth being knocked out?
They're still got the dentist working on him. Here's Wilkes. Around a pick. Follows no good. And ball out to Ohio State.
Unable to finish, but this is just good recognition. Now, getting to that area. The find and the ability to finish shots, so important. And Wesson, a guy that can make outside shots, inside shots. And by the way, to finish the tooth story, I think Chris Holtman went out on the floor and actually stepped on one, trying to see how his player was. Compound the problem.
Both the Wessons have had tooth issues here in the season. So they
stitch.
Kept the dentist busy, the Ohio State dentist been busy.
It'll help the health plan.
Andre inside to his little big brother.
How about that? Well, that's what they say, feed the big fella.
That and
right?
They did. Caleb about 70 pounds lighter than he was when he first showed up in Columbus. And he's still at 230,
70, maybe a little bit more.
Well, keep him away from you. Put a few pounds on hanging with you.
That's right. Brown trying to go baseline against Wesson. Wesson holds his ground. Another turnover. C.J. Jackson on the fly the other way. Nice. And he's rejected by Wilkes.
How about that? Nice hustle by Chris.
Wilkes pull up three on the other end.
Good job by Moses.
And Moses scores.
And they got to nail him and keep him away.
Man, he got the rebound over Caleb Wesson and went right back up with it.
But one thing about Moses, he can run the floor.
Here's Luther Mahaj, fadeaway jumper, cleared off by Jalen Hill.
Little quick jack without anything.
At the 4 minute mark, number four, hands will kick it out. Ali for three.
Nice balance.
Jackson, wide open look. And burying it is Luther Muhammad.
And that's why you run the floor. They love to cover the corners. Good baseline drive. No coverage on that weak side.
Ohio State bounces back in front by two. Hands works inside. Drew the foul. No baskets. It's going to be a foul before the shot. 3:25 remaining first half.
Well, it's the holiday season, and why not Moses stepping up big time? But the ability to cover that corner is so important on the defensive end. A little nylon by our state.
Back in Chicago, Ohio State with a two-point lead. The Wesson brothers are keeping the Ohio State dental plan very successful. And while Andre had 2.5 teeth knocked out earlier this season, Caleb got hit in the mouth this week, had a tooth come through his lip. They're keeping Ohio State head athletic trainer Jeff Dietz quite busy. He has a history in ice hockey training. He said he's seen about 12 teeth knocked out in his career. These are the first basketball teeth, but he said the brothers have zero sympathy for each other. And you know what? He's gotten a couple calls from mom, Stephanie Wesson, this week, just pleading, please send my boys home for Christmas with a better smile than I sent them to campus.
All I want for Christmas is my two front teeth and one not going through my lip.
New meaning to that song.
Exactly. Riley on the inside for UCLA.
How about that? Fortunately, he has that left dominant hand able to finish in traffic.
A third tie of the ball game here with a little over three to play in the first half.
I don't know if you're talking about the play with a lost tooth, though.
I would not be.
No, I would be. You know, with your good looks.
That's not a good look. Another turnover by Ohio State. Wilkes thought about a three. Instead, lost it going in. That's double-digit turnovers.
Well, they average 12 a game. You've got to do a better job with the basketball. There's just terrific use of that hand. You can see all the red shirts around. Fortunate enough to deliver with the southpaw. Did a better job when they got it to the corner and cut to the gut like this. Missed the cutter.
They'll take the outside three. Woods off the mark, but it's all the way out to Muhammad on the long rebound. He'll give it to Washington.
Kyle going the other way, I think. Aarons.
Foul on Aarons. His first. Steve Alford, sixth year as the head coach, and it's been a hot seat for him. Last year, 21-12, they were 11-7 in the Pac-12, and they lost in the first round in the first four in at Dayton. And it's always a hot seat when you're not undefeated or not in the top 20, whatever.
I think when you sign at UCLA,
yeah,
it's very warm. But he's had kids leave. This is a young group in so many aspects. Not a good play. Not valuing the ball. Hold
on. Steal by Muhammad.
Well, he is a strong-looking kid. A shorter version of LeBron with those shoulders. Nice hesitation. He does that well. A nice give.
Inside, tying it up is Jalen Hill.
And Wesson wisely doesn't nick him. Get a cheapie. Get a little high-low going. Now Wesson doesn't have a touch. He's getting a little itchy.
Now they get it to him at the free throw line.
I like that, though. Good. Take it yourself.
Muhammad got caught in the lane. Kick out. Woods for three. And Wilkes with a rebound.
Better job rebounding that long one for UCLA.
Here's Wilkes on the offensive end, had it stripped by Caleb Wesson and off his knee, out of bounds. So another UCLA turnover, too many for Steve Alford's club. Coming up, AT&T at the half. Adam Clark and Seth will get you caught up on all the scores and highlights from around the country today, plus a preview of our second game here in Chicago as the Blue Bloods get together, Kentucky and North Carolina, our second game this afternoon from United Center.
We're talking about three of the teams we didn't mention. Of course, Rupp, Joe B. Hall, and the great tradition of Kentucky over the years.
Wesson gets it back outside. Washington's going to keep trying the three until he gets one right.
See, that's easier, though. If you try and do it individually, you got to have some ball movement, some reaction, get the defense to collapse. Steve Alford not happy with that sequence, but I think more so the turnovers, Brad.
No doubt.
Hey, Brad, you're from Minnesota, and you relocated.
A long time ago.
Look at this. Here's a little relocation. Not from Atlanta, but long range as well.
Good dish inside out by Caleb Wesson has given Ohio State that three-pointer and the three-point lead. Five lead changes. Biggest advantage, UCLA led by five.
And you know, both coaches, one's going to worry UCLA about turnovers, the other's how are we going to attack this zone in Ohio State? Nice.
Nice cut to the basket.
Sure was. Great setup out of the timeout. Steve on top of it with that one.
Young on the inside. Into Wesson. And now the pull up by Muhammad.
This kid's a player. Plays with confidence. Good ball movement at that time. Nice pass by Young. And then a kick out.
Final 20 seconds, first half.
I'd run the same play, a little flex cut on the baseline. Usually coaches like the ball screen. I would trap this late. That's what they run, Moses coming out.
Hands will start to make a move at the 8-second mark. Almost lost it. It's the last thing. It needs another turnover before the buzzer. He'll take it himself. Missed it, and Ohio State will have the halftime lead. Luther Muhammad, the freshman out of Newark, New Jersey, doing his thing here in the first half for seven. And the leading coach, Chris Holtman, with Jamie.
All right, Coach, how do you feel like you've handled that zone defense down there?
Not very well. We got a little bit of a better feel for it as the half wore on, but we weren't very good early against it. We played inside out a little bit, relaxed and made some shots. That's going to be key. They're long. There's a reason they're playing their zone. They're long.
Coach, thanks.
Thank you.
Buckeyes with a halftime lead. Game that seesawed back and forth. The Buckeyes with a three-point cushion as we head to Zook and the guys in New York. The CBS Sports Classic is sponsored by Bud Light, enjoyed by giant blue fictional knights everywhere. Jersey Mike subs, be a sub above. And by AT&T, more for your thing, that's our thing. UCLA's biggest lead in this game was five. Ohio State's biggest lead is where we are right now, by three. Just about set to start the second half. Brad Nessler, Bill Raftery. Raft, I think, as Chris Holtman told Jamie, going to the locker room, we're not playing very well. Shooting 36%, and they still got the lead.
It's interesting. They did a couple of things, a couple of wrinkles against the zone. That's the key. They were stagnant, didn't move the ball, didn't cut very well, but UCLA just coughing it up.
They're coughing it up.
Major issue.
Yeah, to the tune of 12 turnovers as we take a look at the first half stats brought to you by Zaxby's. 12 turnovers for UCLA. That is not going to cut it. Let's check in with Jamie.
Well, Chris Holtman's not going to like what Steve Alford just told me, which is they're going to stick in that zone defense. They're going to show a couple different variations, but Alford has liked how active they have been in that zone defense. Offensively, though, he's been able to keep his frustrations in check. I asked him about those 12 turnovers. He goes, I don't know, atrocious passing, bad dribbling, but our young guys have to figure it out on the offensive side.
Let's see if they do to start the second half.
And you know, Brad, the difference between the 2-3 zone of UCLA and Syracuse, the UCLA coach has a personality.
Jim's going to love that comment if he's watching. On the drive, Jackson to kick out. Caleb Wesson thought about a three and then delivered a three and missed it. And Riley will clear it off for the Bruins.
He had those two fouls. He's got to be a little more dominant. Nice early kick here. I like the pace, pushing and then making a nickel dimer.
And that is a third foul on Luther Muhammad.
And he's the one that's really done a nice job with the pull-up game and the deep one. The nickel dimers are costly. I know you save your pennies, Brad, but goodness.
Yeah, that one he didn't need.
You gotta hope you get some help if you can't turn and square up.
So Kyle Young in for Muhammad.
Another turnover potentially, and
it was. Wow. Number 13. Going the other way, Jackson.
CJ Jackson.
Really CJ nice. Second field goal.
Nice two-man play there with Woods. Love his experience.
Senior out of Charlotte. Gives Ohio State its biggest advantage. Hands on the drive and fades away and got it.
Well, he can dominate, no question about it. It's how he provides a lift to others. I think that's key as they get into their Pac-12 season. New man early now, right back to the standard. 2-3.
Trying to get it to Caleb Wesson. And now rejected. Moses Brown with a stick back in. UCLA running the other way for Ali.
What a nice give. And the big thing, the push of the dribble, the speed dribble by hands, negated that little slap from the rear, the deflection.
UCLA back-to-back buckets makes it a one-point game. And Caleb Wesson, a quick touch to Young inside. They move it around the perimeter and get a three. And off the mark, it hands with a rebound, and then the foul on Keyshawn Woods.
Yeah, not a good foul either, but the ability to push the basketball before the defense gets set is so important. Nice block. And have it just here, that little push to get it away from the defense, and then the give and adjustment at the rim is really solid. Fast break basketball. Run when you get the opportunity and be patient in the half. The mantra of UCLA.
Opportunity to take the lead back if that goes short. Rebound off to Jackson, who whips it to Young, and now it's Andre Wesson, and he's fouled.
Now guys like to put that belly out there instead of taking the hit.
Foul's going to be Prince Ali.
A nice little early push here, known more for his shooting ability. Fortunate there when that slide by. Boy, if he had just stayed square, I think he would have got the call.
Andre Wesson goes in line to shoot two.
So Andre Wesson's first trip to the free throw line. 13 out of 17 on the year so far from the stripe.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Mom and dad here in Chicago.
Well, it's got to be a great thrill having one child play major college basketball. Two, they're going to be pretty special.
And on the same team and only a year apart. And as I said, it's Andre, who's the elder, and his baby brother is the guy that just tipped it out and kept it alive.
Yeah, we're tough to keep him off that glass, squeezing him. Nice pass. He really does a nice job finding.
On the baseline, Young, good look from Wesson.
Now they found a little wrinkle now. Get the big guy in the game, don't foul, and make some decisions.
Hands on the drive against Jackson. We'll kick it to Ali for three. Nope. Off the mark. Jackson will bring it up for the Buckeyes.
Can't be settling for deep ones. You got to drive.
Oh, good luck inside.
And nobody got back. Fell asleep on the defensive end. Got a quick timeout out by Steve Alford.
Nice dish by Jackson as the lead is swelled to six. Biggest of the game as Steve Alford calls the timeout.
Chris Holtman really got his guys to do some nice things here. Used the big fella to make some decisions, a little adjustment, but young at heart. A really good understanding of getting down the floor, beat that defense. Moses Tardy.
That's the home of the national championship and Final Four in Minneapolis. There's the trophy. And there's how many titles these four teams in our doubleheader in the CBS Sports Classic have accumulated over the years. 26 national championships. You'll be up there freezing your backside off in Minneapolis.
I'm going to be using your name up there.
Yeah, I don't know if it's any good anymore. I'm not sure.
We'll give it a shot anyway.
You might as well try. 3 minutes into the second half, Ohio State has its biggest advantage up by six.
Tried to run a little brush screen dribble, a handoff.
Ali back on top to Hands. He's going to take a three.
Well, that's tough off a timeout.
Probably what Steve said. Don't take a bad shot to open up after this timeout. That's what they did. On the other end, Andre Wesson for three.
He can deep thrust it for this team, and they need some outside shooting against this zone.
And that's a little bit of a danger time right now for the Bruins if they can't come up with some offense. Trailing by nine.
I think they're in the attack mode. A little hold on the baseline rub. I don't know which Wesson they got it.
It's going to be 24, I think. That'll be his second. And here was Andre on the offensive end.
Easy it is. Now he can stretch it, of course. Why not?
Mom says that's how I taught him to shoot that three.
Yeah. I mean, who's going to lay claim to teach him how to whistle?
Wilkes off the baseline, inbound pass. Thought he was fouled, didn't get a call.
A little more pace to Ohio State. Look at this load up early. Nothing more than a shove by Hill.
Trying to stay with the big fella.
I talk about Wesson, just a big time load up. Look at him. You can say all you want about doing your homework early. When he lays the leather
That's
on
right.
you, say goodnight.
On the inbounds, Young straight up with it.
Nice quick release, too.
And Caleb Wesson walked with it. Hopefully he didn't turn his ankle trying to get that rebound. And he's all right.
He's a big, strong kid and a great feel for the game as well. And this is one of those rules. If you fall to the floor, you're going to get the walk called.
He says, I did all that work for that.
For naught. I like this little post-up shooting. They can get Riley going.
Riley likes to work inside. He scores.
Dodo. Ride him. He's got a tough match with Woods, though. Now they go to a little 2-3 on his side. Nice ball fake.
Woods on the baseline. Cut off by Riley.
He wants that three, doesn't he?
Here comes the three from number three. Off the mark. Wesson trying to keep it alive, but it comes free to Ali. Hands, make it Wilkes short.
I don't know. Everybody was matched up. Run something.
Jackson. And rejected by Wilkes. Up and down we go, but can anybody score? Prince Ali gave up a three. Penetrates that time and drew the foul. Nope, offensive.
I like the aggressive maneuver. You got a jump stop, be under control. Oh, pace is picking up just a little bit. And I think they got the right call, unfortunately.
Ali with his second foul.
It's time for trivia.
And there's Woods holding his ground. Took a pretty good shot.
Remember the drill yesterday? We're working on picking up that charge.
Right.
It pays off. Practice makes perfect.
Went through a whole part of practice just taking charges. Well done.
All right, are you ready, Ryan?
I'm ready.
He's ready.
Take a look at the AT&T Fast Analysis, Raph.
The inside-out play, we saw this earlier in the game, the ability to relocate, get yourself in position, get those puppies set, and drill it. Excellent ball movement, and then the feel, the cut, and really understand the geography around that rim. Young with a nice finish, but Wesson with lovely touch for the big fella.
Good things happen when 34 touches it, whether he scores or, as you saw in that last pass to Kyle Young.
He is their go-to guy, no question about it. He can dominate on the block, selectively find some people, and
for the first time, a little 1-2-2 full court pressure here. Maybe speed them up, and let's see if they drop back to that zone.
Nice job against the press by the Buckeyes. And they're right back into it, and Caleb Wesson, the kick out to Washington. Off the mark on the three, and it's going to be a push, I think, on Andre Wesson from behind, trying to get the rebound, or
I think you're
maybe not.
It's against UCLA. I think you're even on the other Wesson.
So Wilkes picks up the foul.
I like that really different look that time with Wesson at the elbow and then kicking across court. It's a nice subtle improvement. Look at this ball movement, picking that zone apart.
Woods will try another three. This one's off the mark as well. Rebound to Hands.
It always looks better if you knock that shot down, doesn't it?
Yeah. They got the looks they wanted. Just couldn't get them to go. Riley from the outside, and he drills a three.
This kid is going to have a nice year, I think. Playing with a little more confidence. Broke that jaw early in practice. Some toughness about him.
Redshirt freshman who's got 5.5 and 9 for the game.
Wouldn't take that many threes, but good at it.
Young got it to Caleb Wesson. Wesson with 12.
Boy, can he body search too. He lays the wood on you.
12 points, 8 rebounds for Caleb.
Tell me when you're ready.
And Ohio State's going to go to its bench and bring back in Muhammad.
It just pins you. I mean, there's nothing you can do. You're so vulnerable to begin with, standing upright. Write a note home, see if mom will help you.
Jalen Hill talking to Caleb Wesson now as if to say, man, I did my best against you defensively. You threw that shoulder in and I lost my wind.
He is so powerful.
Riley behind the back, up, under, off the glass.
Got to keep working on that right hand too. And a little late getting back.
Muhammad back in there. Remember, he had 3 fouls. That's why he sat for a good stretch of this half.
And he played well.
Oh, the lob inside to Young.
How about that? A lot of people think Washington's going to shoot that jumper, but what a nice find. And the little things that Young does. Alert, I'm sure he gave a lion point to the tip.
Buckeyes back in front by 8. They've looked a lot more comfortable against the zone in the second half. Here's a lob. Wilkes on the drive. It's going to go to the free throw line.
It might be Washington on the side. No, they give it to Wesson, I think.
Yep.
How about that? But look, see, a little point, a little direction, and a pretty good shooter. So you got to get out and contest that jump shot. Nice feel. Young.
Kyle Young plays so well on that baseline. He's been a difference, I think, in the second half. For
great
the Buckeyes.
Point. Great point. Finding spots to go. Feels very comfortable in that low post area.
Chris Wilkes at the free throw line. That's only the second free throw UCLA's taken today, and he's taken both of them.
Yeah, they got to get to the line more. That's settling maybe for deep shots.
There's a guy that could take deep shots in his playing days.
I'm sure he took a couple of deep shots from Bob Knight. They're great pals. They talk to one another.
He has unbelievably great stories about Coach Knight.
He does.
A lot of them we can't tell, but
much more sharper. Look at this. Nice job with the pass. Washington again with a nice find.
And the foul on Moses Brown. Tomorrow on CBS, a little faith goes a long way. Don't miss God Friended Me. Tomorrow after Madam Secretary, only CBS.
And if you're in the low post defensively, you would like God to befriend you if you're going
against this guy. Caleb back at the stripe, where he's 3 out of 4 so far today. 12 and 9, working on a double-double.
A nice touch he has, though. So many places you can spot him and decimate the interior defense. Nice high-low look he provides.
Former Ohio Mr. Basketball, all Big Ten freshman team a year ago. Wilkes bumped by Woods.
Gotta give ground and get another angle. Guys just give it up with the reach in.
One Wesson comes in, another one goes out. That takes away the size factor for Ohio State.
That's as slow as he'll move all game, too.
Going to get a breather before the next media timeout.
Small man's game right now. Yeah, like this now. Turn and go.
That's Riley on the inside. Had it blocked. The big guy underneath. Moses Brown doesn't miss.
Well, Brown really does a nice job reacting on that one.
That's why he's shooting 67% from the floor.
Well, he's got to get himself a little offensive game as well.
Defensively, tried to get the block there. Did get a piece of the rebound. Comes free. Out to Washington for three. Yes.
He's a shooter. And what a great look by Luther Muhammad.
And a game earlier this year against Purdue, Fort Wayne, where he got six threes. He's got two here this afternoon.
He's a shot maker.
Brown on a hook shot kind of lost the handle, but they're going to call foul on Young, I believe.
I think you're right.
So that'll send Moses Brown to the free throw line after this timeout. Ohio State's matched its biggest lead. They're up nine. The CBS Sports Classic is sponsored by Buick, proud partner of the NCAA. Microsoft Surface. And by Taco Bell's Rolled Chicken Tacos. Ohio State by nine, a tale of two halves against that zone, Bill Raftery.
And Brent, just not really moving the basketball and moving bodies. Everybody matched up on the perimeter. Occasionally a little bump for a ball screen jumper, but nothing as well done as this second half. Ball movement, body movement, flashing the post, and why not? The decision maker, the big guy. With a great feel, he can finish with that jump shot, that little high-low maneuver, something that's very effective thus far in the second half.
And still not shooting well from the floor, but of their 20 field goals, Raptor got 18 assists. So
how about
that's
that?
Good teamwork.
Pretty unselfish. Of course, Moses Brown, this is really a dilemma. He's going to have to work on this game.
He is a 37% free throw shooter. And Jamie?
Well, I know on that play, the fouled on the sky hook really could have helped him out from the Kareem Abdul-Jabbar playbook. But Steve Alford told me before the game it was a little unfair to ask of him to make those comparisons early on in his freshman career. He's actually had to talk to him a few times to not listen to that outside noise and allow his own game to develop within this UCLA offense.
The 7'1 freshman is the tallest UCLA player in 25 years.
It's unbelievable. There's so many comparisons. New York, outstanding student. Catholic School League in New York. And yet he's one of those guys got to work at his game, see how much he loves it. Big upside if he puts it out there.
Muhammad trying to feed it inside. Got it to Young, but he's in a lot of traffic, and he is fouled by Wilkes. His second. Our CBS Sports Classic continues. When we're done, number 19, Kentucky, taking on ninth-ranked North Carolina. Last time they met was in the South Regional a couple of years ago. Luke May hit that big shot in the last second for a win that propelled North Carolina onto the national championship. We saw a fantastic matchup 2 years ago between those two teams. We talked about it a little bit earlier. We'll reflect on that when we get to that game. Right now, back to what we have here, which is an 8-point Ohio State lead with 11 minutes to go.
You better cover the corner if you play this Ohio State team.
Jump, stop, and slip, but no travel. And Chris Smith for his first basket.
Good piece of officiating, too. He locked that pivot foot.
When they get it into Caleb Wesson against the zone, good things happen.
Yeah, the 1-3-1's been a foul. Look at this left hand. He is a scorer.
He's going to get it himself, and he's fouled and after the rebound.
Washington's got an array of deliveries.
That's three on Cody Riley now.
Now watch this pivot foot. It just locks it in there. You mentioned a little slip. It was with the lead foot.
So Caleb Wesson back to the free throw line. He is on his double-double right now. 13 points, 10 rebounds. A little bit tired on that free throw. Missed his last two.
Singleton Menard on the floor now to see if they can get this thing going on the offensive end.
What's the hole?
These are two outstanding players I just mentioned, too. Highly recruited, well thought of, just finding their way.
Inside and through a double team. Nice job by Bernard.
He can drive. There's no question about it. Nice footwork, too. Nice patience around that rim area.
CJ Jackson picks up his second foul right there. Sends Jules Bernard, the freshman on LA, to the free throw line. That's his first point.
Nevada, Ohio State with that 2-0 in the league to start off. Pretty comfortable.
They were, this time last year, they were too. They were 2-0 in the Big Ten.
Well, how about four? I think he's four times the coach of the year, Chris Holtman. And by the way,
doesn't matter what league he's in or where he is, he's coach of the year.
You know, Jamie went to get her hair adjusted today. Guess who was in there?
You're not supposed to tell us.
No. I told Chris.
Her hair adjusted.
Well, what do they call it?
I don't know, but it's not adjusted.
Adjusted.
Jamie, you had company there anyway, right?
Yeah, well, I was getting my hair done, and Chris Holtman did walk in. He saw me in a state that I didn't appreciate the Ohio State basketball coach seeing me, but it was because his wife was there. So I guess so we got to catch up instead.
So you both got your hair adjusted.
You did.
You know, Jamie, I told him you said he was getting his hair taken care of as well.
The UCLA team. Well, the foul underneath. We'll send Andre Wesson to the free throw line. And that's three on Chris Wilkes.
Unselfish team. All stems from the top, too.
And the Wesson brothers have missed their last four free throws. Singleton coming out, and Hands comes back in for UCLA. And Andre talked that second one in. Seven for him for the game. The lead is five. We're under the 10-minute mark, second half.
This has been very effective, losing the little curls, high-low.
Riley asking for it on the low block, doesn't get it.
And looks with good motion now. Gotta go.
Eight on the shot clock. Hands working against Caleb Wesson. And
I don't think they're going to give it. I don't think it was Wesson. I thought it was the weak side help.
If it is on Muhammad, it'd be four, but I think they're going to call it on Wesson.
Huh.
Yep. So that's three on Caleb.
A little cheapy for him. But if he just pressures you with that tummy, you're gonna
feel it.
Move a few yards.
Jalen Hands, a sophomore out of San Diego. 3 points in each half. Second one rims out. Woods will clear it for the Buckeyes.
Much snappier with their passes. Chris.
Work it to the baseline. CJ Jackson three.
Found the guy. Gotta separate. Can't have one guy matched up. It's gotta be two on one in that zone.
Jackson tried to press the issue defensively and got a little too close to Bernard.
You want to play him for the shot. You know he's going to drive. And he's just good action on that baseline. Getting yourself available. Very nice overload, quick look, snap, bang. Get him organized.
CJ, their top three-point shooter. 21 on the year and shooting around 40% from out there. So Jules Bernard getting some work. And at the free throw line, perfect so far.
He didn't make a shot, but he loves to put it on the deck. Nice frame, powerful player. And he's sitting at 1-2-2.
And a little three-quarter court pressure from the Bruins. They tried this a little bit earlier. And no problem as they get it to Jackson. He might just go up with it. He will and scores.
Well, that's confidence. You've been around because you've got a big three against Indiana, winner last year. Kid's a gamer.
hands in some traffic. And Wilkes now with a cutter. Got it back. Try a second time, maybe a third. Nope, not going to get a third chance. Caleb Wesson's a woo. Got some elbows flying.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. Some chicklets might have been on the deck.
We don't need any more teeth flying around.
The dentists are going to be busy for these programs right here. Like the protection though.
So we're going to walk it down the other way. Chris Smith picking up his second foul. Make that his third foul.
Look at UCLA, they're long, lanky, right? Physically up front, matching up with Wesson is a monster for.
And he has missed his last three free throws, however. Hands going the other way with a pull-up jumper. That.
Well, he is so confident on that shot. Nobody at the rim either. Able to stroke it.
UCLA gets it back to five. Every time they've gotten down to five or four, the Buckeyes have had an answer. So they need a defensive stop here. Will they get it? Wesson for three. They did.
See, now the press does work. If you don't make that shot, great to attack, but you got to convert. Nice hands. Look at this guy.
Everybody hits the deck. Possession arrow will be with UCLA. 7:49 remaining in the ball game. Nice hands by Woods, and then everybody hits the deck. These guys have been battling all day long. Our game summary, Ohio State still really hasn't warmed up, but they've got so many assists on their baskets, and Caleb Wesson with a double-double, his third of his career. You know, we talked in the open about UCLA hitting a bad stretch Wednesday night. They got it handed to them by Cincinnati, 29-point loss, and the question was, how do they respond? I think they might not win the game, but they've responded.
I think they had to be competitive today. Right. I mean, this is, to me, in a sense, this was the season. Are they ready to reach back? Are they ready to be as tough-minded and go at people when they come after you? The old coach's term is, can you take a punch?
Right.
And I think they've been good and resilient. This, to me, is a harbinger maybe if they're going to grow as a team because they're too good. And as they get into their conference, you know, get better. There's obviously the goal of all is getting the NCAA and then do some damage. But very admirable, I think, thus far.
Yep. Here's hands on the drive. Rebound off to Jackson. CJ had it knocked away, but it comes free to Muhammad.
Well, that layup, you got to make that when you get that close hands. What a great move.
Almost got a steal there. Now Woods inside. Round and round it goes.
Well, that gamble outside cost him. Be patient. Don't turn it into a goal.
Ohio State by seven with seven to play. And Wesson. Riley inside is fouled by Caleb Wesson.
They need Wesson on the floor, but this is one of those deals. You got to finish this, and you pay at the other end by that gamble, the sellout out at the free throw line.
Now, do you keep Caleb Wesson in there, or do you get him out of there with four fouls?
I think you got to get him out. And what do you think?
Yeah, Young's coming up to the scores table.
I didn't win many games, but I think I was right there. Well, they can play small. They can afford it this particular game. As we noted, Brown not on the floor, but not as big an offensive weapon at this stage in his career. So you can play a forwards game.
So we'll see with 7 minutes to go how long Caleb Wesson sits with those four fouls. Cody Riley has struggled this year from the free throw line. Got the second one up. And again, a little bit of backcourt heat from the Bruins.
It makes you decide what you want to do once you beat it. You want to settle, you want to attack. If you don't make it, it's purposeful. Woods is one of those guys who can beat you in the crack.
That should have been a foul, but Jackson will take it. He got the jumper to go.
He took it on the chin.
He did take it on the chin.
Wow.
So CJ Jackson having a big second half offensively. Here's Bernard for three. Off the mark. Andre Wesson with the rebound.
Yeah, that's the one he's got to make. Get better at that. You know he can drive.
The lob to Young and a double-digit lead. A great pass from Woods.
How about that vision from half court? You know you're negligent in the defensive transition. When you give up one that deep, don't recognize, but experience that awake. Woods on the money.
Keyshawn Woods with the lob. Young with the flush. The Buckeyes by double digits.
The folks, my friends in El Paso, Gary, Jamie, and I and our crew will be there to bring you the Sun Bowl.
Do you have my number? I don't know if you'll return.
Yes, I will. I have your number.
It's rather enjoyable trip, I'm told.
It's fun. A lot of fun.
They go a little zone now, a little tit for tat. UCLA, not known as a great deep shooting team.
Riley on a penetration. Still didn't finish underneath. Back out. Nice pass. Hands gets it right back to him. Boy, Andre Wesson, I guess, blocked that.
He did a great job recovering. Exposed that ball like that.
Wesson now on the other end.
Look at Young.
He just does all the dirty work.
Pick up the pieces.
And then the three by Jackson.
And no mention of Young on that play, but the coaches will notice.
And the lead swells to 13.
And they go back to man.
Wilkes will try a triple. And UCLA's missed their last three shots, missed opportunities, a couple of them on that last trip.
Yeah, a little switch to the zone, threw him off a little bit, but a nice pass here. But look at that recovery. Sensational reaction, helping your partner out. And right here, CJ is so much of an integral part of the way they play, whether it's cracking, cutting, putting it on the deck, or knocking down deep ones.
CJ 12 of his 14 in the second half. And now Andre Wesson back to the line.
Yeah. CJ went around 40% from three. That's pretty, makes some plays. The key guy for that club.
Riley goes out and Chris Smith comes back in for the Bruins.
New test right now for UCLA. Can you muster up a little comeback here?
Can you get one more push with 5 minutes to go? Otherwise, it's going to be curtains. As the Buckeyes have built the lead to 15. Wow, it seems like it was a four-point game just a minute ago.
It's amazing. They're not as relentless, UCLA. That's why they haven't finished deals.
Jackson knocks it away from Ali.
You can see the difference in terms of being together. Ohio State's together.
Yeah.
He's a work at attaining that particular goal. Nice slip.
Nice pass inside, and finally they got one to go on the interior.
They may have to get out of that little 2-3 zone and attack a little bit. Let's see if they do. Yeah, straight up, man.
Pretty much had to because time's on the Buckeye side.
Exactly. Time's on everybody's side but mine.
Jackson, whoop, he got hit that time, and he's going to the free throw line for three. I didn't see the last one when he got hit on the baseline, but hard to miss that one.
Yeah, out in the open like that. Just the terrific reaction here, whether it's the screen, the ability to do some little things. Tough.
CJ, senior out of Charlotte, got the first. And there's the team pregame. Somebody said, open your eyes, Raft. He said they are.
Chicago will do that to you.
So three free throws for number three and the third one upcoming.
There was no one in the place except for you and me.
Uh-huh.
Remember that one?
Yeah, exactly. He got them all.
Mm-hmm. Tough giving up a three-shot opportunity at the free throw line.
On the drive, his hands, he tips it back in.
Boy, is he quick in elevation.
Quick second jump. 10 for Jalen Hands. As we work under the 4-minute mark. Ohio State in control. There's a steal. They got one out of the man-to-man.
Let's keep this energy up.
Hands for three. Got it.
He loves that shot. And they're coming back. I like it. I like it. You're showing me a little ticker.
Bruins not going away. And a timeout taken by Chris Holtman.
Well, you got a guy like Hands. You got to hand it to him. This kid wants to be a winner. Off guard, trying to run the point, do so many things in this club, but the freeze at nylon. Bruins back in it.
Ohio State, Caleb Wesson, double-double today.
He mixes it up. No question about his patience around the rim. We saw the three. Going to need to adjust with the hand and his partner. Little backcourt. CJ takes it right in the jaw. Still that mid-range floater. You got to have it if you're a little bit undersized. And why not stretch the D? Big-time delivery. But a little guy.
30 between those two, along with 18 rebounds. Here's CJ, who's got 17. 15 of those in this half.
And Wesson back on the floor. He should touch it.
Picked up that fourth foul before sitting out, but now with only three to go, he is going to touch it, and he's going to score the first time he touches it.
I mean, he could work for FedEx, UPS.
Delivery?
He can wrap you up and nail you as well as mail you. Great body. They got the Nile on the one side. He's able to turn his man.
Hands a little heat check. Missed that three. Rimmed out. Jackson with a rebound. And we'll bring it up as slow as he can. But guys don't need to be in any hurry.
He loves this one. Nice pump. Say goodnight.
Oh, the strip by Wilkes. And then turnover, Ohio State.
Once in a while, he beats you the low post, then he brings the cargo out deep. He makes that adjustment, get to the rim.
Boy, nice hands by Wilkes, though. Previous possession, he had no problem. Backed in Brown and scored off the glass. Wilkes has only 1 point in the second half. Here he is out on top. Trying to spin his way to the hoop, and he does draw the foul. Man, and that's it.
Number five, huh?
Yep. Wesson will foul out.
A little dribble spin and a little slide by. Gets the attention of the officials.
And so far, no movement. I thought it was his fifth foul.
Yeah, such a factor for this team. Well, he must have had a wrong number on him.
So that's only the second point for Chris Wilkes this half. Apparently called that other foul on Woods.
Oh, they switched it. Okay.
Yep. And that keeps Caleb Wesson on the floor.
Yeah, because he had the four. Need to get a little action defensively. Stir it up, get an easy one. Would be a perfect trap there if they wanted it.
Jackson's going to go to the hole and draw the foul.
Pretty good recovery, though, by the defense. Some clubs do a great job of reading, using that sideline, and you can just see the little bang there by Hands, but good, pretty good recovery by UCLA.
I think C.J. Jackson thought, well, let's use some clock, and then he saw the opening and thought, well, I can at least get to the free throw line, and he is 3 for 3 from the stripe, make it 4 for 4, 18 points for him. Monday on CBS, hang out with TV's funniest neighbors, new hit comedy starring Cedric the Entertainer and Max Greenfield. The Neighborhood back-to-back episode starts Monday, 8, 7 Central, only CBS. CJ Jackson, 19 points. In his second half for the Buckeyes.
A lot of perimeter, got to attack. Oh, goodness. Too high.
And the turnover problems they had in the first half cropping up now when they can least afford it at the two-minute mark.
Now, if they're going to get better, they got to value the basketball.
Yep.
They just can't cough it up on a consistent basis, particularly the high-level programs they're going to run into.
Jackson this time will back it out to use some clock.
He was dying to run that floater again, I think.
Thought about it.
Who's the new point guard?
Woods will kick out. Jackson three. Got another one.
How about that? Let him slide off the ball. And Woods gives him the opportunity to knock it down. No inside.
Wilkes will try to answer and does. Two-pointer on the baseline.
Yeah, no inside post presence for them, though. They got to do it all the perimeter guys.
Ohio State en route to its 11th win of the season. Eight by 14 with a minute 20 remaining. And Raff talked about this earlier, the upcoming schedule for the Bruins. They play Liberty, and then it hits the Pac-12 starting January 3rd against Stanford.
And people are saying, well, is the Pac-12 strong? Some people don't think it is. Not as deep as it generally, or they would like it, obviously. But getting better, and I think it started a little bit today. Not enough, but at least they've got some an attitude about themselves, right. A presence that didn't exist in Cincinnati. So it's been a tough road trip, but maybe going home, get things, the troops organized, and get it going again.
Nice pass into the front court to Caleb Wesson. And now C.J. Jackson out here in front of us trying to use some clock here in the remaining minute.
It's all milk time right now.
1 minute remaining.
Now he's going to take the hook in the lane. There was nobody to throw it to.
And he got the time off the clock. That was key.
Right.
Didn't get both.
And now Woods, a foul on Chris Smith.
That's stopping the clock, not necessary, really.
Talked about the Bruins schedule. And what's ahead of them? Ohio State looks like this, High Point, and then it's the Big Ten.
Here we go. Well, pretty deep conference, too.
Yep, for sure.
Jim Delaney, the commissioner here courtside. I don't know how he got his seat. But
he has good seat.
Not bad. He must know somebody. But he's pretty proud of his conference. As he should be.
Yep. Chris Smith got them both. And we're under a minute.
Jim Delaney played basketball in New Jersey, by the way, in high school. St. Benedict's Prep. There's a Carolina guy, so we know where his hopes are next game.
North Carolina, Kentucky, just about, 15 minutes after we're done here. So to the free throw line, Luther Muhammad. Missed one game this year, the Minnesota game. Kind of bumped his shoulder in the Syracuse loss.
With that body, you can't get hurt.
I was going to say, those shoulders are pretty hard to hurt when you're built like he is. This is a guy Chris Holtman told us yesterday. There's the commissioner. And he does have a good seat right to our left.
Not bad. Sure you helped him get in.
Yep. And Luther Muhammad hit him both. Chris Holtman told us yesterday he's a guy we just had to have, the freshman. And I can see why. He's going to be a good one.
He's really good.
Smith just touched the front of the rim with that three-point attempt, so out of bounds to the Buckeyes, and the shot clock and the game clock virtually even right here. Oh. 11-1 start for Ohio State, and already with two wins in the Big Ten. That is a good way to look at things right before Christmas.
Pretty impressive. First UCLA, go home, get organized, get it going. Long season ahead, just about getting better.
They're going to fall to 7-5, while the Buckeyes go to 11-1. And they throw it up. There is 0.2. They're going to put a little clock back on. It doesn't matter, but they got to keep everybody on the court here to just make it official. And again, it's the final 0.8 seconds for one of our officials today. We wish him the best in retirement. Dick Cartmell is final moments as an official after 35 years in the business and heading to the locker room for the last time. And I'm sure there's some emotions. He's got a smile on his face right now as he runs into Hank Nichols over there in the corner. Well, the three of us are not going that far away because we've got another game coming up. And that'll be Kentucky and North Carolina after Inside College Basketball. Presented by Progressive Insurance. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports. We'll send you to Adam Zucker in New York right after these messages.